What is up, YouTube? Welcome back to another video. I'm gonna go get some groceries. I gotta stack up again. And yeah, I'll see you in the pre-workout meal. Alright, so I'm about to head into the grocery store. I'm in the car right now. I would normally take you in, but it's raining outside. And also, I'm only getting like two things because I'm leaving for Charleston. And like literally tomorrow, I leave tomorrow afternoon. Alright, so this is what the mini grocery haul consisted of. It was a little bit different than what I initially said. I got some 96.4 ground beef, some ciabatta rolls, I'll freeze these. Some like pita bread, it's called naan bread, some turkey, and some raspberries. All right, so here's my meal. A little beef and rice action. There's a little bit of cheese in there too. If I had avocado, I would use avocado, but again, I'm leaving tomorrow, so I didn't want to get eight avocados and then come back and then they're all rotten and bad and overripe. So just threw a little bit of cheese in there instead of avocado. So I wouldn't say it's a pre-workout meal, but it is a meal. So all right, my man has arrived.
It's time to carb up and get into this workout.
All right, Jesus Christ. Sorry, I'm gonna run him through a workout. We just got back. Tonight we're having beef and turkey tacos. The beef is 96.4 and the turkey is 93.7. So it's cooking right now. And I'll assemble it and show y'all. All right, there she is.
Hell yeah, TPB up in this.
You're watching Trailer Park Boys, yeah. I'm gonna eat this and we're just gonna watch some Trailer Park Boys hang out. But yeah, I'll see y'all in the morning. Pretty nice day out. Oh, it's bright. Alright, so we're both running the same thing today. It's my favorite flavor, lion's blood. I'm going 3/4 scoop. I think he's going a full scoop. And then I'm gonna run nitrosogen. Yeah, how's that taste? Very good.
Yeah. Oh, hell yeah, dog.
Oh, hell yeah. Let me know what's good, dog.
Get that back in arms today.
Yeah, hell yeah, let's go. Oh, yeah. An angel falling from heaven
above. I put you. I gotta switch the lines.
Yeah. Yeah, what's good? Let him know.
He's 16, he's gonna go for a plate today.
Yeah.
Hey, by the way, for the record, he already got it, but he's going for it again because he wants it on camera.
You want a lift off?
Yeah.
Just got
with
him.
Come on, push that shit. Push it.
Go.
Come on, fight. Oh, he got it though. He did get it last time. All right, we just finished up. The gym's pretty empty right now. a Saturday, like midday. Everyone from college like went back to their to like their hometown and everything. So we're headed out. I gotta leave tonight too to go to Charleston. So I gotta pack still. All right, I'm all packed up.
Got the backpack on.
We're headed out. So I'm gonna be in Charleston pretty soon, and I'll continue the vlog there. So I'm lifting in my home gym, and it's very limited equipment. Pretty much the goal of today's workout is to show you that like you can get a lot done with not much equipment. I started out in this home gym and I didn't have much equipment, and I pretty much built my physique and my chest especially in this gym. I also remember seeing like a video online about how people that have like a big ass gym and a bunch of different options versus people that have limited equipment and not much stuff. The person with limited equipment tends to have a better physique at the end if they both don't know what they're doing. So to kind of explain that, when you have a home gym and you have limited equipment, you can only do a certain amount of things, and most of them are with barbells or dumbbells, basic movements. But when you have a lot of options and you don't really know what to pick, you can kind of switch it up too often. And if you switch it up too often, you're not hammering down and mastering a certain exercise. So how I did it was I started out in my home gym and I didn't touch an actual commercial, like an actual gym outside of my house until like a year into lifting. So by the time I got to an actual gym, I knew what I was doing, and I knew like I had a routine and everything. I knew exactly what I was doing. So that was very helpful. If you do have access to a gym off the rip, like right away, I would recommend that you just pick certain exercises and stick to them for a while, and then make your switch if you think something would try something out, see if something works better. It's just all about training on instinct. So I'll show you the gym and everything, and I'll run you through a workout. So let's get into it.
All right, so here's the home gym. It's very simple, but it gets the job done.
Side note on like the home gym stuff. So I'm not saying that my circumstances were bad by any means. Like, I'm very blessed to even have a home gym. I was just saying that if you have a home gym or you're able to get a couple of pieces of equipment, you could easily turn it into like a spot where you could get a full workout in. It's all about just making the best of your situation. At first, when I started working out, I didn't really know what it was like to go to an actual gym and have a bunch of stuff, but when I got out, it was nice because I knew what I was doing. And also, I had made some progress. You make a lot of progress, especially when you're in your own element. It's like a whole different thing. You can have some great workouts in a home gym with limited equipment. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. So I know the last workout, the one at the home gym, I only had a couple clips and I didn't have a lot. That's mostly because my brother is down in Florida right now. And so he couldn't film, so that's why all the shots are static. I got burnt up, so I always get burnt up the first time I try to tan, but it's kind of like the first layer. I wouldn't recommend burning up. I didn't mean to, but it just kind of happened. But yeah, I'll be back in Charleston pretty soon, honestly, like a month or so. I get out for summer, so I'll be back here. But that's about it. So I hope you enjoyed the video, and I'll see you in the next one.